take a look at dividing factorials. So when you've got a number like 8 factorial over 6 factorial, really there's a part of this that's redundant in the two. There's a part of it that we can reduce out. Because 8 factorial really means 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And 6 factorial really means 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. So because we've got the 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 on the top and also on the bottom, and because it's multiplication, there's no addition signs or subtraction signs separating these, so we can reduce. So because we've got the same thing on the top and bottom, we can actually cancel all of these with all of these, leaving me actually just 8 times 7. So 8 factorial over 6 factorial is in fact just 8 times 7, which is 56. Let's take a look at a second example. Do it over here. So if I had, let's take a smaller one, 5 factorial over 3 factorial. It's the same thing. 5 factorial is 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. 3 factorial is 3 times 2 times 1. So these reduce with these, since it's a fraction, and you can reduce the top and bottoms, leaving me 5 times 4, which is 20. Now if you did this out, and you did this out, and then you reduced, you'd also get 20, but this is a faster way.